welcome to today's episode of CCTV. Christina Carlyle here. I'm a personal trainer, I'm a nutritionist, and welcome to CCTV, the place to be if you're trying to get more happy, healthy, and fit. Now, last week I wrapped up a series I was doing on how to be that girl and lose weight this holiday season, or avoid holiday weight gain, and how you can navigate parties and events and different places and restaurants and avoid gaining weight. I showed you how to eat and different tips and tricks and everything that I could, you know, possibly give you to help you out and set you up for success. While you're eating this holiday season. I love this time of year because I always get to hang out with family and friends. And I was hanging out with a girlfriend of mine, and we're sitting there and we're looking at the times. Like, we both realized that we needed to get some stuff from the grocery store. So we went together and we go into the grocery store, and I see this big glorious display. It's like, of pomegranates. And I'm like, okay, this is happening. And Denise kind of made a comment like she wasn't very familiar with pomegranates, or, you know, she's never really bought one and seeded it. And if that's intimidating to you, or if you're not familiar with pomegranates, this is the time. They're in season from September to January. And they're a red fruit, and they're kind of like the opposite of a pepper. You know, when you get like a green pepper, you core out all the membranes and the seeds and you eat the shell. Well, a pomegranate's opposite. You have to cut off apart the shell and get out the seeds, which are stuck in the membrane. Like, the only thing you can eat are the seeds. And the seeds are one of the most powerful sources, potent sources of concentrated polyphenols and antioxidants. And there's just so much nutrition content just packed in these teeny tiny seeds that I wanted to make a video today to show you how you too can seed a pomegranate, how easy it is, and also give you some ideas of ways that you can use the pomegranate seeds. So the first thing you want to do is cut your pomegranate into different sections. I recommend cutting it across and then quarter it. But what you want to do is you want to put those pieces, soak them under some water for up to 5 minutes. And then take them out, and then one by one, you want to put those pieces back into the bowl and kind of rip them apart with your fingers and kind of pop the seeds out with your thumbs. And doing this is helpful because the membranes will float to the top, and all you have to do is scoop them out with a slotted spoon. And that's it. It's really easy just to pop out all the seeds, and then once you scoop out all the membranes, you rinse them off, you pat them off with a paper towel, and you're ready to go. They kind of remind me of craisins. I don't know if you've ever had dried cranberries on top of a salad. They kind of have that tart kind of flavor to them, but they also kind of remind me of a tapioca because they're like squishy, but they get this little pop, and there's a little grit into them because they are a seed. So they're crunchy and they pop and they're tart, and they add these little bursts of flavor, and you can use them in so many different ways. I ended up making a salad and just threw it over the top. It was really delicious, but I love them especially this time of the year because it adds that vibrant burst of flavor and color. So you can really mix it up and put them all over your dishes and kind of make them more like Christmas-like. Pomegranate seeds taste great over pork and chicken and different beef dishes, over salads or sides. There are so many different ways you can use them. And honestly, you can't really go wrong if you just want to try to sprinkle a few on top. They're so easy to pick off in case you don't like them, and they're great on their own. So however you want to use them is up to you. They're also really great in tea. They're almost, because they have that boba consistency. I don't know if you've ever tried boba tea, but that little pop, they taste great in drinks as well. So I just wanted to share this really easy video with you in case you've never tried them. Tis the season. So since they're around, you might want to give them a try. Just throw them in your grocery cart. They're about $2 a piece, and they last forever. Once you pat them off and put them in Tupperware, they can last up to 2 months in your fridge. So easy breezy, and I hope you like this video. If you like it, please like it so I know. If you don't want to miss next week's episode, please subscribe now because I make a new video every Thursday. I hope you've had a very happy Thanksgiving, and I will see you next time right here, same place, every Thursday. Bye.